Hey, Shalom Israel. All praise, honor, and glory goes to Yahweh, Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, double honor to the apostles and elders of great millstone, and Shalom to the elect. Alright? This is, let me get Tobit, chapter 13. I'm going to start at verse 6, man. I always bring this out, man, but this is a beautiful precept. Tobit 13 and 6. If you turn to him with your whole heart and with your whole mind and deal uprightly before him, then will he turn unto you. And, you know, I want to stop right there because, you know, us doing these lessons, man, it may, no matter how it sounds, for one, if you stop doing this work, the judgment that you set could be for yourself. And that's the scary part about this truth, man. Your tongue could fall upon yourself, man. All right, here it is. You talking about scoffers. All right, you follow the truth, you become a scoffer, man. You talk about guys who ain't diligent. You stop being diligent. So it says, if you turn to him with your whole heart and with your whole mind, all right, so you have to eat those words up, man. You know? Like they say, in the world, you made your bed, now I'm laying it. Now, our bed need to be made up. It's like, our bed need to be made up in righteousness. All right? The scriptures say in Psalms 23, that of what? That he leadeth me. Let me see if I can grab it real quick. I'll be back to that one. He making me to lie in green pastures, yep. Psalms 23. It's locked here. Like I said, man, it's something for me and for Akim. You should think upon this as well. Psalms 23 and 2. He maketh me to lie in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Alright? So, our words... All right, through the spirit of Yahweh, Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, it's for rest. The scriptures say, I am for peace, but when I speak, there are for war. You know? All right? This book is for us, man. All right? So us reading out of it is for ourselves first and foremost, and then to rebuke. All right, let's get that. 2 Timothy's. Because how would you understand it if you don't apply it to yourself first? That's true understanding. 2 Timothy 3, 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God. And is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and for instruction in righteousness. That the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished into all good works. And like I said, the good works, all right, these works of the Lord, allow us to be furnished, man. Alright, build out knowledge, wisdom, and understanding for that great day. So if you not taking good heed to what you're saying, what brothers are saying around you, alright, what's the purpose of being in this truth? You're just as good as a two-third. Tobit 13 and 16. No, 6, lock it. Therefore, see what he will. I'm going to start from the top again. If you turn to him with your whole heart and with your whole mind and deal uprightly before him, then will he turn unto you and will not hide his face from you. All right. So the most you got to read this and believe it, man. You know, you should pray. You should pray to be a man of your word and that your word has power, man. You know, hey, the scriptures say this word is as a two-edged sword, you know, so it's cutting the person that is the message is going to and yourself, man. It could cut yourself if you don't swing it right, man. You know, hey, man, that's the worst feeling in the world when you fuck up and your student or the person that you're teaching brings your word up, your words back up in your face. You know. You know, it says, therefore, see what he will do with you and confess him with your whole mouth and praise the Lord of might. All right. And the scriptures say you can never go far enough. So we need to do more videos and praise the Lord of might and extol the everlasting King. In the land of my captivity, do I praise him? Is not this the land of our captivity? All right. Egypt, the land of America, also known as Babylon the Great, also known as Egypt. All right. And declare his mighty and majesty to a sinful nation. O ye sinners, turn and do justice. Who can tell if he will accept you and have mercy on you? You know, because this is our plate, you know. Let me see if I can find out what David says. He prepared a plate in the presence of, my enemies. You know, and then let me see. It's a lot. Try to find it in Psalms. If I could, Lord willing. Something like that. David said, let me see. Prayers. Oh shoot, it's locked, yeah. I was right there. Alright, this is Psalms chapter 23 and verse 3. He restoreth my soul, he leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his sakes. And as you can see, this is one of my favorite precepts as well, man. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Alright, and like I said, man, the words of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah is everything. That's why they need to be within us. So that in that great and terrible day, and even on days where you feeling at your low, man, they can lift you up. Hey, the scriptures say, be continually with a man of understanding. Alright, so that when thou miscarry, he can basically lift you up, man. He can sorrow with you, man. Alright, and that's this truth, man. Alright, and how we hear the word, man. Through the men out there on the highways and byways doing the works, true sincerity, man. Our brothers doing them epistles during the week. Alright, of course the apostles and elders. Alright, those men been doing it. Alright, so we just gotta follow. It's like here. Follow. Alright, the examples that have been set before us. You know, and just like Apostle Hart said, man, if you don't know what to do, follow the man that's going in. All right, because he's running, man. He's trying to get to that finish line, man. All right. So, you know, ask the Lord for spiritual guidance, understanding. Like I said, man, understanding what you're saying. All right, because it's not just to reprove them and rebuke them. It's to reprove and rebuke yourself. Yea, though I walk in a valley, through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. So, in the presence of Esau, what is not the Most High preparing the table for us? Alright? Starting with the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of this word, man. After we get that, in the name of the Lord, of course, which is within the word, alright? Then all things gonna be added unto us. Proverbs 15 and 2. The tongue, it says, a soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words store up anger. Verse 2. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright. You know? So, you're going to use the knowledge to your to the best of your ability to help you. Alright? Because like I said, you know, some guys, they use the knowledge, but it actually hurts them, man. Especially in the long run when they fall out and they realize they've been speaking of themselves. And that's a scary thing, man. That's why we have hope, man. And that's another reason why we should stay humble, because it's this word is, you know, hope. You know, we have hope that we're gonna make it, man. You don't know, all right? This gospel is all about hope, man. All right, you're hoping that these words can only help you, man, and not hurt you. What you hoping that these words, all right, remain with you, rather, if I could say that, all right, and you're not going against it. Let me see if I can find a good one on hope. I think it's one in the New Testament I want to get, but I can't remember it. First Peter 3:15, this is a good one. But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asks you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. All right, so how you gonna give answer if you don't understand? You know, you gotta understand what you're saying, man. You know, that's another thing. Ask the Lord for knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. I forgot you said it in the Hebrew. But yeah, man, you ask the Lord for knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, man. So that this word may enter into you, man, and change your life for the better, man. Alright, I'm going to read it one more time, and then I'm going to close out. It says, but sanctify the Lord power in your hearts, and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. So our duty, alright, is to have the light shine through us, man. So if that be the case, like the brother said, GMS is time. Alright, you gotta constantly be. Alright, you gotta constantly be on your A game all the time, man. You know, when you out there fighting, or like say a professional boxer, you know, sometimes it could be what, six months before his next fight, man. Alright, but what? He's always constantly in the gym. He having his mind girded on the fight, man. He's always in the ring. So that when he actually gets in the ring, all right, it's nothing to him, man. You know, if you're not fighting all the time and you get hit, all right, your whole body gets shut down, man. You know? So you got to always have your mind thinking upon his truth. Studying. All right, what more can I do, man? What am I not doing? You know? So with that, I hope brothers edify. Shalom, Israel.